Does not do well to dwell on dreams and forget. best friend that passed away in March, how much I felt his spirit surrounding me. I mean, it's true. More clearly in times of great trouble, so true. At 31, mischief managed. Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire. 32, if you want to know what a man's like, take a good look at how he treats his inferiors, not his equals. Ashamed. Never be ashamed, my old dad used to say. There's some who will hold it against you, but they're not worth bothering with. Rubius Hagrid. 34. It matters not what someone is born, but what they grow to be. Albus Dumbledore. 35. We are only as strong as we are united, as weak as we are divided. 36. Your devotion is nothing more than cowardice. You would not be here if you had anywhere else to go, Voldemort. 37. Numbing the pain for a while will make it worse when you finally feel it, Albus Dumbledore. 38. Anyone can speak troll. All you have to do is point and grunt. Fred Weasley. I love Fred. 38. Curiosity is not a sin. We should exercise caution with our curiosity. Yes, indeed. Albus Dumbledore. 40. Twitchy little fair, aren't you Malfoy? Hermione Granger. 41. Just remember, it's taken you 3 years to notice, Ron. Doesn't mean no one else has spotted I'm a girl. Hermione Granger. 42. Differences of habit and language are nothing at all. If our aims are identical and our hearts are open, Albus Dumbledore. Harry Potter in the Order of the Phoenix. 43. Give her hell from us, Peeves, and Peeves, whom Harry had never seen, take an oar from a student before, swept his bell hat from his head and sprang to salute, as Fred and George wheeled about to tumultuous applause from the students below, and sped out of the open doors into the glorious sunset. 44. I think we've outgrown full-time education. Time to test our talents in the real world, do you reckon? Fred Weasley. 45. Harry witnessed Professor McGonagall walking right past Peeves, who was determinedly loosening a crystal chandelier, and could have sworn he heard her tell the poltergeist out the corner of her mouth, "It unscrews the other way." Harry Potter and the Order of the Phoenix. I love McGonagall. 46. I think I'll just go down and have some pudding and wait for it all to turn up. It always does in the end. Luna Lovegood. 47. Just because you have the emotional range of a teaspoon doesn't mean we all have. Hermione Granger. 48. You can laugh, but people used to believe there were no such things as the blubbering humdinger or the crumble-horned snorkack. Luna Lovegood. 49. I mean, it's sort of exciting, isn't it? Breaking the rules. Hermione Granger. 50. We've all got both light and dark inside us. What matters is the part we choose to act on. That's who we really are. Sirius Black. 51. A difference in neglect often do much more damage than outright dislike. Albus Dumbledore. 52. Youth cannot know how age thinks and feels, but old men are guilty if they forget what it was to be young. Albus Dumbledore. 53. Things we lose have a way of coming back to us in the end, if not always in the way we expect. Luna Lovegood. 54. With wit beyond measure is man's greatest treasure. Harry Potter and the Half-Blood Prince. 55. says people find it far easier to forgive others for being wrong than being right. Hermione Granger, 58. There's no need to call me sir, Professor Harry Potter. 59. You're just as sane as I am, Luna Lovegood. 60. I'm a wizard, not a baboon brandishing a stick. 61. Age is foolish and forgetful when it underestimates youth. Albus Dumbledore. 62. Once again, you show all the sensitivity of a blunt axe. Nearly a listener. 63. It is an unknown we fear when we look upon death and darkness, nothing more. Albus Dumbledore. Potter and the Deathly Hallows. 64. It is the quality of one's convictions that determines success, not the number of followers. Remus Lupin. 65. No, Harry, you listen, said Hermione. We're coming with you. That was decided months ago. Years, really. 66. Harry was left to ponder in silence the depths to which girls would sink. 67. That one's more trouble than it's worth, said Harry. And quite honestly, he turned away from the painted portraits, thinking now only of the fourth poster bed lying waiting for him in Gryffindor Tower, and wondering whether Crutcher might bring him a sandwich there. I've had enough trouble for a lifetime. 68. Every human life is worth the same and worth saving. Kingsley Shacklebolt. 69. He must have known I'd run out on you. No, Harry corrected him. He must always known you'd always want to come back. Oh, 70, my favorite, after all this time. Always, said Snape. 70 words are, in my not so humble opinion, are most inexcusable. Source of magic, capable of both inflicting injury and remedying it. Albus Dumbledore. 72. Not my daughter, you bitch. Molly Weasley. 73. And Percy was shaking his brother, and Ron was kneeling beside him, and Fred's eyes stared without seeing. Ghost of his last laugh still etched upon his face. Whew. I hated when Fred died. 74. It is a curious thing, Harry, but perhaps those who are best suited to power are those who have never sought it. Those who, like you, have leadership thrust upon them and take up the mantle because they must, and find to their own surprise that they wear it well. Albus Dumbledore. 75, he can run faster than Severus Snape, confronted with shampoo. Fred Weasley. 76, why are you all staring? Demanded Albus as he and Rose craned around to look at the other students. Don't let it worry you, said Ron. It's me. I'm extremely famous. 77, of course it is happening inside your head, Harry, but why on earth should that mean that it is not real? Albus Dumbledore. 78. I've always wanted to use that spell, Minerva McGonagall. And 79. All is well. Now I am going to do something else. Because I think Lily Whispers I gotta get a good picture of the books so I know. So
the first time I ever read Harry Potter, The Order of the Phoenix was my least favorite. The second is Harry Potter and the Prisoner of Azkaban, because we got introduced to Sirius Black. Three is Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows, because it's amazing. That's why. They're all amazing, but this is just my list. Number four is Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire. Number five is Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone. Number six is Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets. And my number seven is Harry Potter and the Half-Blood Prince for two reasons. The first reason is Albus Dumbledore tragically passes. That's one of the reasons. And the second reason is you think all the way through that book, and I think that, hold on, Lacey, hold on. I think there was two. Is there only one more after that? Okay, so you think from all the way to the end of that book to all the way to the end of the Deathly Hallows that Severus Snape killed him just to kill him. You don't know until the end of the Deathly Hallows that Severus Snape was actually a good guy, and he was trying to protect Harry because he was Lily's son. And that's one of my favorite scenes in the movies, and that's why I wanted my friend to put that on my Tumblr, is when he does the expo. The doe comes out, and everybody knows that the doe was Lily's Patronus. So when she passed away, Severus Snape was so heartbroken.